was the first 2-inch eyepiece I bought for my 12-inch dog. It has a very nice magnification and sharp views. Why I think mainly this eyepiece is a very nice first choice? Because, at least with my setup, it's a 12-inch dog, F5, I get with this eyepiece 166 magnification, 6x. So it's a nice field of view to see planets, planetary nebulas, little faint objects, galaxies that fit here. Even the big Orion Nebula, if I watch through this eyepiece, the Orion Nebula, I can see some details and some even color, which I can't with other eyepieces. This has a lot of weight, it's true, but it's a characteristic of these large eyepieces. It has 680 grams, so more than half a kilo. And if we take account that with a Barlow, which has more or less the same weight from Explore Scientific, a 2-inch Barlow that I have, it will be heavier. I have here, with this Barlow and this eyepiece, I can get 333x of magnification. For example, you are looking at Jupiter. You can see with a good seeing. You need a good seeing, of course, to have that magnification. And you get a lot of detail. The Eskimo Nebula in Gemini. You can find it with 9mm and see it through the 9mm. And then if you want a bit more of detail and magnification, you put the Barlow. So the Barlow is good to have with this and other eyepieces. It's my opinion. So I get two eyepieces, one of 9mm and then another with the same characteristics, 4.5mm. It's very nice. More than that, I don't like to use Barlows. Another thing that is very, very useful with this eyepiece is to use as a finder to the object you're going to see. For example, if you are looking to a faint object or tiny object with and you struggle to find, I love star hopping. With this eyepiece, you go more or less with, for example, with a telrad, which I use for this. You go more or less to the place where it is, and then with this eyepiece, you start searching the area. And it's very nice because it's an advantage of 100 degree eyepieces that people sometimes underestimate, which is when you're near the object, if you are with a plossel, you may not find that object right away. But with a 100 apparent field of view, you will find better because maybe you are passing near the object, but with this eyepiece you will see the object pass through the edge of the eyepiece. It's easier to find that, and then look, it's there, and you adjust to the object. So I use this as a finder and to watch too the faint nebulas, the little objects and faint objects that I struggle with other eyepieces. Then if I want more magnification, I just put the Barlow. It's already in the position and that's okay. I even sometimes use the Barlow and this eyepiece to go to the object. But only this, it's fair enough, it's good enough. Now, summarize the technical stuff. It has a rubber here, and it's okay. I usually use like this, not like this. I use like this. I like more, and here I have this is for the comma corrector. This works well with the comma corrector, and I have this space for that. But This, I have to tell you that this works very well with an inexpensive focal reducer. I have a focal reducer at 0.5x, and if I screw, I take these spacers, and I screw directly to the eyepiece, to this eyepiece, the focal reducer, it will have very nice bright and nice views. Usually it distorts, but in this case of this eyepiece, it doesn't. If you put right without anything else, right, screw it right in the barrel, you will have, I don't know exactly the focal length it will be, it will not double. In this case, the 0.5 will not put in this 9mm into 18mm. It will be less. So I risk it will be around 13 or something, but I don't know. I just know that if I want in an object, for example, the Orion Nebula or bigger objects, with this not enough, I just put my an inexpensive focal reducer and it works like a charm. We have a field stop of 15.7. If you are going to use this as I am with a comma corrector, I will make sooner a review about the Bader MPCC, which I like very much. You will have to know that the field stop here is 3mm in the above the barrel, in the black part of the eyepiece. So it's easy to make the account. You just measure to the black, to the barrel, the barrel's shoulder, and then you take account of that 3mm, but it's another story. So it has an eye relief of 12.5mm, and it has technical stuff, nice technical stuff, like EMD enhanced multi-layer coating, which is good, nitrogen purging, which avoids internal fogging, which is good too, and it is waterproof. I put just this technical stuff because they are important to qualify this eyepiece, not as an inexpensive one, but for me it's a premium eyepiece. I don't know, maybe the Televue, another, they have the best ones, but relation with the price and the quality, this one gets in for me the best position. The views are very nice, sharp views, even with a barlow, with nice seeing, of course, no astigmatism, and you will have a bit of coma in, well, it depends of the telescope, but in my setup, a 12-inch stop, you will have coma at the edge. What I could do, I did, and it was to use a coma corrector, which works, and now I don't have coma at all through all the field of view, and even I have sharper views with a coma corrector and this eyepiece. So it's something to take account, because people, at least me, when I bought this, I thought it will not have any coma, but it has. Well, it's like that. Cheers!